What is cyber crime and how it is applied for how it is applied on social media?
Okay. No, the cyber crime, if you say the term, is really very broad. So, in layman terms, I would say that cyber crime is basically a crime which is computer oriented crime. So, it is very different than the conventional crime. So, unless conventional crime, it is the criminal activity is basically triggered by the using of computers or any peripheral devices or any other device, electronic devices which are connected on internet. So, there are basically two types of cyber crime we basically categorize.
Yes, sir.
One is cyber illegal, and the second is what we call is cyber dependent. Now, cyber enabled crime is crime where computer is used to trigger the crime. Maybe I will say online harassment, right, or online defamation. So to use a conventional crime, when a criminal is using the computer or the peripherals as a platform, then it is a cyber enabled. Second is really important, which is cyber dependent. So where the computer is not basically used, rather it is the target. Suppose you have a website and there is a criminal or a cyber hacker or hacker is throwing a lot of traffic on your website, or suppose there goes an attack where it is a denial of service and your website is down.
Yes, sir.
So such attacks are basically cyber dependent. So in these kind of attacks, basically it is information and communication technologies, which is technology which is used. So not only computer, there are other peripherals also. So there are other network devices which are connected to the network. They are also being targeted. Not only the IC.
Yes, sir.
So cyber criminal, they actually commit such crimes either for the monetary purpose, or there can be indirect reasons also. Like they may be political influences, or there may be some personal reasons.
Yes, sir.
You'd be surprised to know there are approximately 3.7 billion users which are there on social media. And there are 7 social media profiles which are attached to a single person.
Yes.
So in context of social media, the effect of cybercrime on social media is multiple. A simple tweet can go wrong, and a simple tweet or simple post can be defamatory, or it can go to an extent where people are victimized by data frauds or data theft. One thing which is very upcoming in cybercrime is selling of illegal things on internet. Social media is being used to sell illegal things now. Like, there are so many articles which are illegal, but social media is used to sell them online. So broadly speaking, if you say the social media is used to trigger such attacks, it broadly divided into two categories. One is reconnaissance. So reconnaissance is where a user has posed or user has posted posting over or oversharing the information over the social platform. So till the time the information is limited, it is absolutely fine. But in case of reconnaissance, there's a lot of extra information user places on the internet. Cyber criminals use this information and they find out their potential victim and they design and they trigger the trial that potential victim. Second is fake news or rumors. We all know what is happening in COVID-19.
Yes, sir.
The disease are not spreading as fast like news on social media are replicating. Everyone on social media is giving suggestions. You should do that for COVID-19, you should do that for this pandemic, or you should do that or this. Without even one authenticating whether this is a foolproof system or not, or you can say they would not know either whether this is real or fake, but still they will say it. We are seeing that in case of Sushant Singh Rajput, I'm not saying who's right or who's wrong. Social media is anyway doing its trial by itself. So who's right, who's wrong, you don't know. So this is how social media is basically used by criminals for their own benefit. this how what cybercrime is, social cybercrime.